okay? I'm not moving.
That was lovely.
Lovely.
Okay.
Your mask gonna put those inside us.
You know, God created us in His image and likeness. And why were we in the likeness of God? Because you are like who you are around. And they were with God in paradise. And even though we left that likeness by leaving paradise, by Christ coming to earth, by Christ dying, by Christ crushing death, bursting the bonds of Hades asunder, we all have the hope of life eternal. It's just He's not going to take free will away from us. So we want to be like and can be like God again in eternity. So we are like who we are with. So you are like who your friends are. And you are with great friends and great family. Have you, Matthew Warren, a good, free, and unconstrained will and a firm intention to take unto yourself to wife this woman, Kailey Nicole, whom you see here before you?
I have.
Have you, Kailey Nicole, a good, free, and unconstrained will, and a firm intention to take unto yourself the husband this man, Matthew Warren, whom you see here before you?
The servant of God, Matthew, is betrothed into the handmaid of God, Kailey Nicole, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
While vows are not just words, they are actions. And the vow with the ring, which shows eternity, which shows never ending, as our God, as our Christ, who is the Word, who was without beginning. So this is their vow, the giving of the ring.
O Lord our God, bless the betrothal of these thy servant Matthew and Kailey and Nicole, and confirm the word which they have spoken. Establish them in the holy union which is from thee, for thou in the beginning didst make them male and female, and by thee is the woman joined unto thee man as a helpmeet. Wherefore, O Lord our God, who hast sent forth thy truth upon thine inheritance, and thy covenant unto thy servants our fathers, even thine elect from generation to generation, look thou upon thy servant Matthew, and upon thy handmaid of God, Kailey Nicole, and establish their betrothal in faith, in oneness of mind, in truth, and in love. And, O Lord our God, do thou now bless this putting on of rings with thy heavenly benediction, and let thine angel go before them all the days of their life.
So we're asking God to bring his blessings upon them. And this marriage is just full of things that are symbolic, but why? He gives us tangible things, and we do tangible things to know the intangible. Just as it says in the Psalms, let my prayer arise in thy sight as incense, and let the lifting up of my hands be an evening sacrifice. God told us how to worship. There are things that we want them to continue on what has been given to them. They have been given the church. They have been given Christ. We want them to have earthly good things. But first and foremost, before that, we always say their salvation, for that's the most important. Your first walk as a married couple was three times for the Trinity, in a circle for the eternity of God. But what was in the middle of that walk? The gospel and the cross. And if that is our central focus of our marriage, we'll always be fine. It is a blessing to us. Not only did he bless you, but it is a blessing when we get to see the mysteries, the sacraments of God, especially two becoming one.
Although all through her life, Kailey has brought us joy and has always made us very proud. Every parent hopes and prays that one day their daughter will find the right partner and get married. We have no doubt that in Matt, she has found that man. He's kind, caring, and already feels as if he's a part of our big, fat Greek and Lebanese family. We honestly believe that Kailey could not have met a better match, and we love you both dearly. And join me in wishing Matt and Kailey much happiness and a long and joyful life as husband and wife. To the new Mr. and Mrs. Matthew Stevens.
We got a beautiful story, and we've
We got a beautiful story.